Now, I know I've got to be careful of you, little one. On account you were very, very delicate, aren't you? So I'm not going to pick you up because I might hurt you. I'm just going to sweep this little bit of earth into the jar. And you with it. And then I'm gonna take you back to the apartment and show Pris what I found. Oh, you really are the sweetest, cleverest little spider, aren't you?
Who's there?
Hello, Pris. This is J.R. Isidore.
If I let you in, you've got to promise not to talk about your work at the Lace Depot.
Well, I guess.
It's depressing. I don't want to hear about garbage.
Well, sure. But it is my apartment, after all. You two can't just stay cooped up here while I'm at work. You need some friends.
We have friends. Or had, before the bounty hunter got to work.
What's a bounty hunter?
You better come in. I don't feel safe with the door open.
Oh.
A bounty hunter is a professional murderer. Usually he has a contract with the city, around $1,000 for each murder.
That can't be true. Are you sure?
Of course. For some people, JR, androids like us coming back from Mars is considered a crime.
Good evening, JR.
Good evening, Roy.
Good day at work.
Yeah, I guess. But something unusual happened. Let's eat.
What?
What happened to work, JR?
Yeah. You talking about the police and all just reminded me.
Try to think straight, JR.
A policeman came to the depot looking for another of the quota guys.
Was he called Deckard?
I didn't hear.
Who was he looking for?
A Polakoff. Works down at the Bayside dump. They said he was a child molester. Hasn't shown up since.
That means they got to him. Poor Mr. Polakoff.
We've been running for 2 years, half a lifetime.
Why did you come back to Earth?
Mars is a bad place, JR. Everyone takes drugs because of the loneliness. It's unhealthy. Everything on Mars is so old. The stones and a landscape unchanged since the solar system formed. It makes you more lonely than you can imagine. Roy brought me home.
Yes, we came home. Does anyone else live in this building? I haven't seen any lights on.
Just me.
Why is your face like that, JR?
When the Northeast United States was bombed, I got a big dose of radiation. I had a mask for a while.
Oh. It's how you treat other beings that matters, not appearance. You've been kind. Maybe once you get to know me, you might want to help with my project.
What kind of project?
Human beings decided they wanted to depose God. Heave him off his throne.
I don't understand.
Look at Pris, JR.
Yeah, I'm looking. Yeah.
What do you see?
I see... she's beautiful.
Something beautiful that was made to be desecrated. To serve their basest desires until she got worn out. If they find us, JR, they will kill us. They will blow a hole in Pris, out of which her life will leak onto this filthy floor. I think when human beings made me, they entered into a contract which they have always chosen to ignore. They took on responsibility for me and my life because we're your own children. And you made us your slaves.
I didn't have nothing to do with it. But you're right. We ought to be ashamed.
JR, I want you to know we appreciate this very much. You're the first friend any of us has found on Earth. Pris will show you how grateful we are. Take him to bed, Pris. Show him some love.
Come with me, JR.
I found a spider. Put it in a jar.
Show us. I've never seen a spider. Let's see. Open it.
Here.
All those legs. Humans love animals of all kinds and will do anything for them. You know what I think, JR? I think it doesn't need all those legs.
Hey, why couldn't it get by on four? Cut off four and see.
It probably won't be able to run as fast. But there's nothing for it to catch around here anyway. I guess it's gonna starve to death.
Please, don't mutilate it.
It's refusing to move. It obviously can, but it won't.
I can make it walk. See?
No. Let me take it outside. Let it have some time on the grass. Outside.
He's really upset.
Maybe this is the last spider. The last living spider on Earth.
The downtown kitchen was a dead end. Luft wasn't there. Thinking about it afterwards, I wondered if she knew we were coming for her, or maybe she wanted to die somewhere more noble. In any case, the waitress said she'd gone to the city art gallery. We found Luft sitting on a Scandinavian-style bench contemplating The Scream by Edvard Munch. Retz flashed his police badge, and the attendant vanished.
Miss Luft.
Painted in 1893. 100 years. That's 25 of my lifetimes. Maybe of yours, too.
This is Mr. Retz. He's also a bounty hunter. We've come to take you somewhere I can complete the Voight-Kampff test.
There's no need. We both know what I am.
The cop who arrested me is an android. So was Retz's boss. You know him. Gaff. He came from Mars with you.
I remember you from Mars, Retz. You're an android, too. I can't remember your real name, but you've been reinstalled, so I doubt you can either.
Sure, let's go.
Look at that woman's face. We are all standing here being so reasonable when I reckon two out of three of us are doing the same thing, screaming.
You and who else?
Him, Mr. Deckard. A moment ago you referred to Gaff as he, not it, he. If you're not yet screaming inside, Mr. Deckard, I think you're working up to it.
What is she talking about? Let's get out of here. This stuff, it's...
Pictures, you mean?
Bend everything out of shape.
You're being discreet, Mr. Deckard. You're going to do whatever you're being paid to do out of the public gaze. That's very touching. An android wouldn't have bothered. I don't like androids. Ever since I got here, I tried to behave as a human. I wanted to be a singer. I am a singer. Androids are mostly scum. They want more life, but most have no idea what to do with it. But maybe I have too much reverence for humans.
It's admitted it's an android. We don't need to test it.
You didn't ask us if we wanted to be born. You just went ahead and made us without our permission. Then the moment we appeared in the world, you made slaves of us, tortured us, gave us just long enough to taste existence before you snatched it away. Next time you look into an animal's eyes with all your wonder and shame, remember what mine were like.
You can't talk like that. You're a machine. Shut your goddamn mouth.
Rats didn't aim right. Luft was winged. She crouched in the corner of the elevator, holding her head with her hands, just like the picture.
Oh, you... you bastard rats.
That's a grand amount. I'm gonna claim it after all.
You wounded her. I finished her off. Besides, you can't collect. You don't have an employer. I'm collecting on Luft and Garland. And with Polakoff, that means I made $3,000 today.
Would you let me go?
Yeah, you're not on my list. You have nothing to fear from me, because I can't claim anything for retiring you.
So you do think I'm an android? Is that what Garland said?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Huh? Maybe he was lying to divide us.
She was a wonderful singer.
They killed people so they could get off Mars. Polakoff almost killed you. Garland tried too.
You killed Luft the same way you killed Garland. Bang! No remorse.
Both android scum. What do you expect?
They weren't the same. You like killing. You just want an excuse. When are you gonna shoot me, huh? When you fail the test?
We'll fly over to the docks. You can give me the test when there's no one else around. If I'm an android... kill me. You will tell me the truth, won't you? If I'm an android, you tell me.
We start the damn elevator.
My fingers shook as I dialed the halls of justice. I told him where to come for Luft's body. She'd be one hell of a singer. And Rhett's was one hell of a killer. A menace. I reckon I knew which deserved to be alive. Blocks in Retz's unmarked prowler and parked on a rooftop under the shadow of a water tank where passing cops wouldn't see us. I gave him the Voight-Kampff test. The result was clear as day. He was human.
If I had a god, I'd thank him.
You were right. Garland was manipulating us. Divide and rule. Mind you, the way you killed Luft in the elevator. Ooh, there is a mean splinter inside of you.
The future of mankind relies on not giving in. Those Nexus 6 androids that destroy us.
None of them have said they want to destroy us. They just want to live.
Listen, pal. I fell for an android once. And I let her go. Turned out she was twisting me. Trying to convince me to stop retiring robots. This is a lonely job. Sometimes we get weak. But don't mistake androids with personalities for human beings. They're blanks. Don't ever believe what they say. I've always got an angle. They can't feel about us the way we feel for them. They're incapable of it.
Rosen gave the Nexus 6 the ability to love. That meant they could step across the line between human and machine. Otherwise, how could Luba Luft sing like that? Well, the logical part of my brain knew the bounty money was my way out of all this crud, and someone else would shoot him if I didn't. So I might as well finish what I'd started. Then, no more executions.
So?
You want me to suggest Bryant gives you work?
Yeah, I'd be grateful.
Drop me off of mission so I can pick up my own car. I'm going after the other two alone.
Back in my own car, I took a few moments so another handful of pills could take effect. Then the video phone rang. It was the familiar mug and charming manner of my real boss, Harry Bryant.
We got Batty's location. We had a call. Here, listen.
Take your time, sir.
Okay. I wanted to say I have some people staying in my apartment.
Sir, I'm having trouble hearing you.
Androids. You're looking for androids. Will they find out I called you?
What's the address, sir? 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 Are you there?
That it?
We traced the call to the city waste management depot. They said you'd been there looking for Polakov. They fingered the caller as an employee named J.R. Isidore.
Yeah, I remember him. Chickenhead, right?
Right. Kodak building, apartment 3967C. Get over there as soon as you can. Once they know Isidore turned them in, they'll move fast.
I can't do any more today.
I think you better get over there tonight before they get a chance to dig in, set traps.
They'll already be waiting for me.
Got the shakes?
No, I haven't got the shakes.
Just don't hang around.
You'll have gathered I was, as the psychs say, confused. I had a plan. Kill the last two, then find a new job. But my conscience wasn't very happy about the idea. And my common sense called out, way down there in the dark, you got nothing left in the tank, pal. Park up and walk away. So what should I do? Answer? Make a phone call. Get some roadside assistance.
Shiny, shiny, shiny boots of leather. Whiplash, girl, child in the dark. Comes in bells, your servant, don't forsake him. Strike, dear mistress, and cure his heart.
The chance to begin again in a golden land of opportunity and...